everybody, how you all doing? Good day to you all, and welcome back to another video on my channel. If you are new here, you're welcome to subscribe to my channel, and as usual, I like to say thank you to all of you, my viewers, old and new. So I really have to apologize to you guys. This video is really late in coming. I'm supposed to upload this video last week, but I was not able to do that. You know, I have little children, and yeah, the weekend was full of activities. My son is playing football, and the children Tony I just starting yesterday, so all day we were, the whole morning we were out and trying to cheer him while he was playing. And yeah, you know, the coronavirus is now in Germany, in Berlin precisely, and so we have to be prepared for any emergencies and take some precautionary principles and measures and kind of stock up necessities just in case there will be a quarantine. So I'll suggest also for anyone who is watching this video who lives in Berlin or who lives in Germany to take these precautionary measures and do what you have to do to safeguard yourself in case there is really an emergency and there will be need for quarantine, so that you are not left in the loop. So moving on quickly, I want to talk about this skilled worker immigration act of Germany, which is called the Fachkraft Einwanderungsgesetz, and this law is to make it possible for people to come into Germany to work and or even study or learn a vocation. So like I said in my last video, I will really suggest that if you have not seen that video, that you just go back and watch that video, and it's gonna be the part two, this one. So yeah, continuing with this video, I will just want to answer some of your simple questions, like if you qualify and you want to take advantage of this provision, how do you go about it? And the first thing that you need to do is to get your qualification recognized. And number two, you have to learn the German language. There's no way about it. So you have to start learning the German language. I believe in German embassies, in Nigeria, or in any other country, they always have this Goethe Institute, and they have facilities where you can learn German. So yeah, German language skill is very important. And a minimum of a B1, B2, depending on the federal state that you will be working with. So yeah, you have to learn German. There's no way about it. If you are coming with your spouse, you also have to, he or she also has to learn German to be able to join you, basic minimum of A1. So the European Commission have this framework for languages, and it's between A1 to C2, and so they are asking for something like a middle range, you know. So the requirement is something from basic to average. So yeah, that is the B1, and the B2 is a little bit higher. Yeah, so my thing is, if you are coming for the medical profession, you need a language competence that is a little bit higher, like B1 B2. But if you are coming for skilled handwork, like, you may not need to have up to that B1 or B2. Yeah, so anyways, you just go through the website, and I will show you a little bit of the demo of the website that I'm talking about.
So to show you a little bit of a demonstration of what you have to do, the first thing that you have to do about this is to recognize your documents. And to recognize your documents, you need to come to this website, anerkennungsindeutschland.de. So in this website, you will be able to find information of how to recognize your profession, if indeed your profession matches what it is they are looking for. If indeed your profession matches whatever, if indeed your profession is in demand. So here we have a German interface, but you can change it here, and you can go to this drop box here and click on English, and so you have it in English. And here you can see recognition finder, professional recognition, work and company counseling. So this is information that is available from the federal government, and so I'm just showing you how you can go about it. So to even know if your profession is in demand, first of all, you have to find the profession. So here you can see the drop box, and you can type a profession. For example, if you are a physiotherapist, this is a medical profession. So let me type physiotherapy. So here we have physiotherapy, and then you can click physiotherapy. So you see, it's a medical specialist, medical, physical. So the profession. So you come here, it's a description of what physiotherapy is all about. They say it's a medical specialist, physical medicine and rehabilitation. So they talk about the field of work. They always describe the field of work, what you are expected to do and the professional experience. So you continue here, it says next. And so you come to what you have to do, where you want to work. So it's important that you choose a city. If you click, for example, you don't know yet, which may be the case, of course, but you will not be able to proceed because they will say the place of work is important. Your application has to be processed by the competent authority at the place of work. You do not know yet where you want to work, just enter any city. You will then receive an example with information for that location. So I'm going to put here Berlin just for example, but I will advise you not to write Berlin because Berlin has no jobs basically. So don't choose Berlin. There are a lot of cities that you can choose from, but don't choose Berlin. I will say that from my own personal experience. So then you can go further here and see they're talking about this medical profession, and so obviously they have another proceedings that they follow for medical profession as it is all over the world. So here is the ASTECAMA, is the regulatory body for medical professionals. And so here they talk about information about professional recognition, and you know, for you to be able to practice this qualification, you must have a valid approbation or authority to practice in Germany. You know how it is with medical profession, you have to even write an exam and all those kind of process, so you can read through it. So this is just a demonstration, for example. So I'm going to go back to this profession finder and put in another profession. For example, you can put engineer. You can put engineer. So here, when you put engineer, you come to this list here. So these are the kind of professional engineers they are looking for. So do you think you have any of these? You know, electronics and all. I think, for example, there will be a lot of people who may have this coming from Nigeria. Yeah, for example, let me just put... like if you are also a construction engineer, so you can put, for example, civil engineering worker. So here they say civil engineering works automatically either alone or either. So you see the information that is given, and so you continue, for example, and they ask you where you want to work. So again, for the purpose of this demonstration, I'm going to write Berlin, and so you can see. You type Berlin and you see the information that is available. So this is where you, if you are in Berlin, so this is how to proceed for the recognition. So let me go back again to that box and type scientist. So I use this generic keywords because most of the time how you describe your profession in your country will be different from how Germans describe it. So it's important for you to put keywords like engineer, scientist, so you can now look which one is available. So here you choose, no, I'm still engineering. So I want to go back and search for scientist. So let's assume you are a scientist. Let's assume you're a scientist, and so you see different categories that they are looking for. So, for example, people in Nigeria may have this qualification, so you can see what is it about. So you can see the description of the job and what is expected of you. You have to go to the internet to do this, and so you click next, and you see again, where do you want to work? I'll put Berlin for the purpose of this demonstration, and then I click search. And so you can see again, computer scientists, and they say competent authority in charge of recognition, and this is ZAV, you know. So this process is mainly for people who have higher education and has been obtained abroad. So you have to go to this website here and go through it, and there is a lot of links here. These links take you directly to that website, and you will submit your document. You first of all, you fill your form. So here they say your institution has to be from a government or government or recognized institution. So for you to be able to determine that, you check your institution here first, Anabin database. So first of all, you have to go to this database and put in your university to see if it's even recognized that it's a government institution that is recognized worldwide. So when you type your institution here and it works, so you have to go here and fill the form and write your documents, your certificate and the number and stuff like that, and then you are going to send this form that you have filled alongside with your certificate to these people. The address of where you will put it, where you will send it, is also there when you fill this form. And you are going to pay a sum of 200 euro for this recognition process in the case of this scientist. And what is also important for you to know is that if the language of your certificate is in these languages: Arabic, German, English, French, Italian, Polish, Portuguese, and Spanish, you don't have to translate it. But if it is not in this language, my target niche is actually Nigerian, so this will be English, and so you will not need to translate your documents. And it's also necessary for you to send officially certified copies. So for Nigerians, you have to go to a notary. The notary is normally done by a lawyer, I think lawyer, so they will put a notary stamp on the certified copies that you want to send along with that field form. So yeah, this is all about this demonstration. Of course, there are more information about the company. For example, you can click here and say finding a job, and so these are job exchange of the Federal Employment Agency. This is EURES. It's also a European mobility portal of a European Commission. It enables visitors to the site to search for jobs and training places, including in Germany. So here is also another place. So you know, just now navigate this link and you can find the information you need. So another page that you really want to visit is this one, Make It in Germany. So you just type Make It in Germany. I'm going to put this link, so don't worry about it. You can click on the link from the description box and it's going to bring you here. But always be aware that you can always change this interface. So wherever you are clicking this Make It in Germany from, if you land on a page that is not in English, if the landing page is not in English, you can always change it. So here you have a variety of languages where you get the same information. So now it's in English, you don't have to do anything. But just in case it's not in English, you can always get English here. For example, if the landing page is in German like this, you have to go here and change it to English, which is what you can understand. Or for those of you who speak French, you can click here to get a landing page in another foreign language. So yeah, we are talking about English, so I'm going to go back to English. So this is their portal, so you can see all the information you need basically. And you can click here for jobs, and they will tell you all about looking for a job, all that you need to do. And also they will, like, for visa, so you are going to see, I would like to come to Germany, for example, to do what. Is, do you want to come to work? Do you want to come to study? Do you want to come to train? Do you want to come to study business? Do you want to come and do research? So whichever one is applicable for you. So for the purpose of this demonstration, let me just click on work. And so it goes on to ask you, are you a citizen of this European Union or the European Economic nations or other first world countries or another country, which would be the case for most Nigerians. So here you come to this place again. It says, what do you have as your qualification? Do you have a university degree or a vocational qualification? So I'm going to go ahead here and write university degree. And so you are going to continue to say, did you graduate in Germany or a foreign country? So I'm going to write foreign country. And then you're going to continue. I have a binding job offer. That means if you already have a job offer. But for the purpose of this demo, I'm going to say, no, I don't have a job offer yet. So these are your chances. So you read, you have completed the university education and you would like to work in Germany. So find out which requirements you meet. So recognition of your qualification, which was what we were talking about in the anerkennungs.com. And so for you to go to you can go to this website. And then you can go to this website for job listings. And then also, you know, if your degree is comparable to a German one or has been recognized, so you can apply to. So if you have gone through the process of recognizing your qualification, you can also click here to see job seekers visa to look for suitable employment locally. So these are the information that you need. And if you already live in Germany, this is also another portal for people who are already here for you to, you know, get more information of what you're supposed to do. But another important thing is that they have a hotline. So you can click on here to ask them a question. And so the hotline is this number here. And so they are open up until, so they just have 16 minutes to go. So they are open from 8 o'clock to 4 p.m. So you can call them except on these days. So the telephone charges is just as if you are calling from a foreign country or if you are calling within Germany, the cost that normally will apply. So so these are also other websites that you can also explore, you know. So you can really use this hotline if you would prefer to call. Other than calling, you can also email them. This is their email address here. So you can see the email address. You fill this form and write the message, and then you send, you see. And you can also chat, you know. So when once they are online, you can chat with them. So for the chat, they said you can chat with us from Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. So, you know, we look forward to talking with you. So now they are offline, you can see. What you have to do is just to click here, start chat. And then somebody should be able to, respond to you. Another way you can also go about it is to look through the frequently asked questions and see if the questions you have has already been asked from other people. And then you can click on the generic answers to see if it meets your needs.
So as you have seen in this demonstration, this is just all you need to do. You don't really need a middleman. There's no need for a middleman. It's just for you to sit down and go through this website and follow the directives and do what you have to do. I think the only money that you have to spend is the money that you pay for, you know, sending it the documents and paying for the fee and maybe your telephone bills. I don't see why you need a middleman in this case. So I think this is something that you can really go through by yourself. And God will willing, you may pull through. And it's important for you who is coming to study, like, you know, in that Make It in Germany link, there's also the link for studying. In fact, just navigate that link. There's everything you need on those links that I put there. So you just go through it. You come in to study what you need, the proceedings you have to take. And the most basic thing you have to do to come here to study, if you're not studying something in English, is for you to learn German. Yeah, and your German language skill will be average, like minimum of B2, you know. And this you have to prove with a certificate. It's called Goethe Institute German, or Test DAF. This one is recognized all over Germany. Or TEIC, or DSH. So these are the names for the language exams that you have to take, and they are also given there in the descriptions in this website that I've shown to you. Yeah, so I don't want this video to go all over the place. I hope that you get the information that you need, and I think that the links that you have to visit are exhaustive enough, and so you can look through the links about the jobs and about the steps that you have to follow. But I have to say this for a fact, coming to Germany to look for a job as a black person is not an easy thing. Yeah, it sounds glamorous, and be that as it may, it's not an easy thing, and I would expect that maybe if you are in the medical profession, you have a higher chance of pulling through. But my thing is, only God knows, you know. God knows who will favor and who will not favor. Why not? You can try. I mean, it doesn't cost you anything. So yeah, if this is your desire, I will encourage you to take a leap of faith and see what comes out of it. Why not? What do you have to lose? So anyways, this is all I have for you today. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you are yet to do so. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to write me an email, blessedom@gmail.com, and I'll get back to you as quickly as I can. You can also write it in the comment section, and I'll also respond accordingly as much as I can. Yeah, I will see you in my next video. Stay tuned. Bye for now.